Magandang araw mga kapamilya. Welcome to Journeys of Hope. This weekend, ano tayo, merong special episode kasi ang ating guest ay si Robi Domingo, na alam naman natin yung balita na kung anong ginawa ni Robi lately. So welcome, Robi.
Hi! Hello, fans! Hello!
Hello, welcome!
Balita. Marites.
Maraming balita, pero para mabuo yung balita ay welcome din natin ang soon to be, but already actually, the better half of Robi, si Maiqui Pineda. Hi, Mike! Welcome!
Hi, Father!
And congratulations sa inyong dalawa, no? Finally, congratulations! So
Thank you.
So I will leave it to the two of you to, sabi ko nga, ang theme ng ating episode today is the journey to the proposal, no? So let's begin with the start of the journey, how you met. Ako alam ko yun, natatandaan ko yung how you met, ano?
Yes. You want me to go first, Mike?
Yes. You explain.
before that pala, ako personally, I know of Maiqui. Kasi high school pa lang, naririnig ko na yung pangalan niya. Okay. From another school na, okay, may chicks dito sa school na to.
Tapos,
siyempre, she will be humble and say, ano ka ba? Pero that's true. Coming from our batch, merong chicks dun sa isang school. Tapos, basketball player. Nasa varsity. Tapos matalino. Ganda. Okay. But I had no interest, especially I had those judgments na, pre-judgments na sa school, mga worst kasi. Parang imposible ko makausap yan. Masyadong iba yung lugar niya.
No wonder Robbie's not mentioning the school, okay?
I know. Baka mabanda ka dun. I will never mention the school. And then, college, we got a bit closer through some friends.
Okay.
Lalong-lalo na yung blockmate ko. Tapos, na nagkadaupang palad kami. But not quite.
Mm-mm.
Okay? And then, sa mga Christmas parties ng ABS-CBN, I get to see her too. Na sabi ko, okay, ba't nandito to? I thought she was like a friend of other artists, celebrities like that. But, okay, I'm just wondering why she's here. And then, fast forward to 2017, ABS-CBN Christmas special. That was one of the longest Christmas specials that we've encountered. Okay?
Araneta.
I'm thankful for the opportunity. I'm thankful na nakakasama kami doon sa Christmas special na yon. But that one was the longest ever. Usually, pagkatapos ng Christmas special, may pa-party yung mga executives for the Kapamilya artist, staff, broad, ganyan. And that was the only Christmas party na feeling ko, pagod na ako. Ayoko na pumunta. Ayoko na talaga. Kasi wala rin naman mangyayari.
Tsaka ang haba nung show, di ba?
Ang haba nung show, tapos wala na akong agenda and all. And then lo and behold, I look at my phone. There was one name. I'm not sure kung kilala niyo siya, no? Tago natin sa pangalan Piolo Pasco. And then that guy said, Marion, nasan ka na? Sabi ko, Papa P, uwi na ako. Masyado nang late. Good na ako. Akyat ka rito. Sabi ko, huwag na, okay na. Akyat ka rito para pakita mo naman sa mga nagbigay sa'yo ng trabaho na nagpapasalamat ka sa kanila. Show some appreciation. And sabi ko, okay, sige na nga. And then when I went up, I saw her again. I saw Maiqui again. Sabi ko, okay. And then that time kasi I was single na for about a year, no?
Ganong katagal na ba? 1 year na yun?
1 year.
Okay.
Yeah, one year. Yeah.
Ang bilis, ano? Ang bilis ng panahon.
Yeah, and yun yung year na deliberate talaga para sa akin na Okay. I'm not looking for anything else. I know I'm not looking for any relationship kasi na-enjoy ko yung pagiging single ko. And then I saw her. And then I asked a few questions, some Ateneo stuff. And then fast forward na lang to around 2 a.m. in the morning. Na I found myself talking to her, dancing with her, and enjoying the whole evening until morning with her.
Mike's mind you, pagod pa yan. Ha? Pagod yan.
Napunit pa yung ano, napunit pa yung pantalon ko. Napunit pa sa gitna at sinabi ko sa kanya, teka lang, magpapalit muna ako ng pantalon kasi nasira. That was how casual we were. Kasi I had no, well, safe to say, I had no plans.
No agenda, that night. No? Just enjoy
the that night. But on my way home, I was with my assistant and my driver there. I told them, drive-through tayo kasi medyo may ano ko eh, may tama na ng konti. Drive-through tayo. Parang nakita ko na yung pakakasalanan ko. I said that.
You said it to them.
I said that to them, yeah.
Yeah, to the driver, to your PA and assistant.
Yeah, driver. PA and my driver. And they were like, ano ka ba?
Lasing
and
ka
now,
ba?
Lasing ka. And now, before we left for Japan pala, sinabi ni Ate Inday sa akin na naalala ko yung sinabi mo sa akin. Yun na pala yun. I go, oh.
Galing.
That was my first shot. I don't know about yours.
Me? Oh yes, well, so I go to the Christmas special every year. And I've only spoken to Robi in two. Out of maybe, I don't know, 8 or 10 times I've gone in over the years. And every time we see each other, even if we're not really friends, in a way, it's always been more, I guess it's very comfortable. You know, we went to the same school. Mm-hmm. We had a similar circle of friends. So it wasn't so hard to talk to him. Mm-hmm. So that's why that night I was alone. Usually I'm with my sister, but she wasn't with me that time. So when I saw Robi, it was like, oh, okay, at least here's someone I can talk to, someone I know among all the other people that I'm not
right. Inamit lang ako.
Because I was alone. But yeah, so we spoke and then we caught up. He said I knew he was single, but he didn't know I was also single. So he thought I was still with someone. Okay. And then when he learned that I was also single, we started sharing.
I'm just kidding.
So Mike's, how did you feel that night after that time together? Sinabi mo rin ba, this is the one? Sinabihan mo bang mami mo or daddy mo na this is the one?
No, I had no idea, no clue at all. I just thought, you know, it was nice to share stories with someone and talk to someone new and learn new things.
But you enjoyed the night. You enjoyed the night.
It was a very, very fun night for me. And it was nice how comfortable and easy it was. But no clues at all or like any ideas of like it going further. Yeah. Or we'd be friends even after that night. Yeah. So it was a surprise.
How did you continue seeing each other, dating, and eventually becoming the couple?
Oh my gosh. Okay.
Okay, go.
This is something I take pride in. Okay, fans.
Okay. Fine, you can go share.
Sino ba ang unang nag-text? Nag-message? I mean, we exchanged numbers, obviously. That
he asked for my number.
I asked for her number. Kasi I wanted to share with her some of the moments I experienced and hopefully that would make her feel better ng mga time na yon. It's like, okay, I had these crazy experiences that you should do. Okay, like going to a bar and dancing on a table. Ginawa rin namin yun. Eventually. Okay. But, sino bang una nag-text?
In my defense, I woke up much earlier than Robi. And then I was gonna save his number when I woke up. So I said I texted lang, thanks, last night, thanks for last night or something. Nice to see you. So I was just being very polite.
Oh,
and okay. I woke up earlier than him. I was the one who texted first.
But to me, iba yung dating nun. Ah. Okay. Okay. I still have it.
Oh, pero itong question ko, dito tayo magkakaalaman. Who asked out for a date, to follow up date or you get together?
Oh, okay.
Okay.
So I would deny the fact na ako yung unang nag-ask for a date. But okay. Ako yun. Ako talaga. I concealed it in a form of a market study.
Oh, okay.
So I was market
how
study,
soon
market
after?
Research.
How soon after that night?
The week after.
A week? A
yeah,
weeks.
1 week after.
1 week after. So before Christmas pa to, before Christmas.
Before.
Okay, go ahead. Yeah. What was the market study all about, Robi?
So I had a bar when I was single. And then we were looking for another location somewhere in Poblacion. And I know she was familiar with that area. So I called her up. So I said, Mike, I'm going to bring my gang with me to do a market study, market research. Can you tour us around Poblacion? And then yun, nag-Poblacion crawl kami, nag-pub crawl kami.
Okay.
Yes.
With your group? Okay, yung dalawa lang.
With my group. But I was out with my friends. I was asking them, ano ba tingin nyo? Okay ba siya? So, yung market study was not for the bar.
But
yung
for
market
Maiqui.
Study,
it was for me.
Maiqui, oh, na, okay ba siya?
At saka, ikaw yung market lang pala.
Oh, the only
siya lang yung market, no?
Mm-hmm. Okay. Ako nga, wala nga akong market ngayon eh.
Okay. And then you enjoyed that night again, I guess, no, Maiqui?
Yes. I didn't really know his friends. I kind of knew them also from school, but I was just like, okay, game. It sounds like a fun night. Why not?
Okay.
So I went, and then, I took them around, and they enjoyed. And some of my friends were there too, so at least it wasn't so awkward because at least like, if this doesn't go well, I'll join my friends na lang.
may plan B pala siya.
May backup plan just in case. But I ended up staying most of the night with them until I think very, very late at night.
Okay, and then
or early morning, like 5 a.m.
5 a.m. Oh my god. And so Rob, ano yun? Tuloy-tuloy na yun. You started dating or was there another market study?
No. What caught me was really the fact na since the day that she messaged, we never stopped messaging each other.
Oh.
Except for 2 days na wala akong signal kasi nasa bundok ako. for a documentary. I was at Mount Apo. But I was looking for signal talaga na... Oh,
and
some...
You found signal.
Yeah, when I found signal, I called her up and told her na sana ano you were here. Parang something like that. Wish you were here.
So, Maiqui, ang surprise honeymoon mo sa Mount Apo.
No naman, please. No more surprises.
Okay, and then, ano yan? You started, first texting, and then you started dating?
Started going out, and then I was fortunate kasi prior to meeting Maiqui talaga, I had a series of adventures as well sa Lakwatsero. I had friends who would tell me to visit this restaurant.
Mm.
And lahat ng mga advice na binigyan nila sa akin, lahat ng mga skills na nakuha ko during that period, I was telling Mike, oh, you wanna go diving with me? And then she agreed. She's afraid of the water, especially she's a big movie geek. Alam niya yung Jaws, ayaw niya ng sharks. I go, relax, I got you covered. And we did that. And then there were a few restaurants that I know na hindi pa niya napupuntahan. And then sabi niya, aba, may taste tong guy na to, ah. Parang pwede. Oh, so, okay. Medyo nakatulong yung journey ko before entering that journey with her.
I hope Mike, your dad will not kill me for this, no. Siyempre, ano yan eh, 'di ba? 'Di ba? Kasi Mikey, we have that ano, alam mo naman yun, Rob, 'di ba? We have that group with sila si LK and all that. So meron kaming Viber group. Siyempre kinakantsawan ng mommy, daddy mo, ano, Mikey, no?
Yes.
Then one time your dad told me, "Okay si Robby, ah." Sabi niyang ganon. I think precisely because of that, you're making Mikey do things that she would not do before, and especially when you brought her to mga orphanages, etc. Parang, I think from time to time, the two of you would go and do some service, you know, some service work. So your dad was very, you know, was very happy about that, Mikey. You know? So I hope he doesn't kill me for divulging.
Well, someone's very happy right now to hear that.
I think you made my day. Pads, you made my day. Okay.
And then, every time I see the two of you, di ba, pag nakikita tayo in some event, remember the last time I saw you together was in that event that we had in the 5th, di ba? Remember,
yeah.
Mike? So,
yes.
And di ba doon, naglolokohan na tayo, Mike, di ba? O, kailan, di ba?
I know.
So,
it's this year.
Robby, lagi ko rin tinatanong, Robby, kailan ba? Malapit na, ilang sagot niya, no? So, I think that time, alam mo ba, Mike, na nagpaplano na si Robby around that time? This is
No idea.
You didn't feel it was coming?
Just recently, the past few months, or maybe like a month ago, where it was like, okay, parang there's something happening.
But all throughout, parang, the way I see you, the way I see the times that I saw you together, parang enjoy kayo. You just enjoy each other's company and what you do, diba? And of course, I think Mikey loves your sense of humor, Robby.
Buti na lang.
Right. Even if it's corny, I still laugh.
She doesn't have a choice anymore.
Tapos mga comment pa ni Mikey na ano, pag may mga jokes si Robin corny, diba? Ang comment ni
yes.
Mikey. You should have heard the other one.
Yes.
Yep.
There's many, many, many more.
Especially when we go to different trips, sasabihin niya na, hindi ko na gets. Can you stop for a bit? Kasi pagod na ako.
Non-stop. Okay. Non-stop.
Non-stop. I have to practice it. Like, oh, if I see a store na nakakatawa, Mike's, tingnan mo to. And then, I don't get it. Okay, wag na. But I told Mikey's parents naman na...
Okay, you told them something, but my follow-up question to that is, you know, how you told them about the proposal.
Oh, wow. Okay,
but go ahead with your story first.
I told them na she definitely... They asked me, kailan mo nalaman? Kailan mo nalaman na you're ready? Sabi ko, because of the events that transpired going to the 2022 elections.
Okay.
Diba? Parang, I told them, she gives me so much purpose. And we have the same goals. We have the same ideologies. And I just can't stop talking to her. I love conversing with her, especially with ideas. Whenever sometimes I get to be distracted with mga certain luhos of the world. She will just pull me back and say, "This is the wants of the world. This is what we need, and this is what you need to do. You are given a voice. Use it wisely." Parang.
Yeah.
Yan. Siya yung palaging lumilitaw na good, yung angel. Kaganoon si Mikey sa akin. Ako yung devil. Eh. No.
No naman. You're not the devil.
Pero Mike, just a question. Conscience. I hope you don't mind my asking you this question.
Sure.
You're, di ba? You're a very private person, really, di ba? and your world is banking.
Yes, so, I know.
So parang, but how did that how did that blend together so smoothly, no? Parang kasi as I said, diba, when I see you with Robi, and I don't see Robi with you in banking events, no, because I don't go to banking events anyway, but I go to ABS events and mga events kung saan kailangan mag-host si Robi. But you seem to be so happy and at home, and wala, parang you're part of that world also, no? So
yeah, well, I think it helps that it's a world that I'm actually very interested in, aside from my financial career. So I do love, film, TV, especially local movies and shows.
Yeah, yeah. Plus, your dad is in that industry.
And then, yeah. So I grew up, with ABS. I'm like a super Kapamilya. So it's something that I also do love. And it's nice that, like what Robi said earlier, like through him, because I'm a very private person and I don't have much of a voice. But he has the voice. So in some way, when I guide him or like I tell him, we should do this, we should do that. So it's like my voice also gets amplified through him because I also want to do so many things, but I'm very private. So I also have like limitations, but it helps that we have the same interests. I'm interested in his world. And from the very start, we were very smart about how we were going to handle it. Always to just keep private things private, some things public, because you can't also escape it. You really have to embrace it at some point that this is his life. So it's something I can't escape. It's a part of my life, and now it's like officially it's going to be a part of my life forever. So it's not something to escape, but rather just to embrace. So that's what we did. And I think it's been working out. He also attends my banking events. He's bet
all the naman eh. Para din sa kaalaman ng tao, Maiqui, bright boy naman si Robi.
Yes.
Diba? Para nice. Naman sa kaalaman ng mga tao. Robi is in the honors class in Ateneo. So.
Well, I believe that quote na, Fads. Upon my meeting Maiqui, behind every good man is the best woman.
Nice, yeah.
Behind every good man is the best woman. Yeah. Yeah.
Nice, very nice. Okay, let's talk about planning for the proposal.
Oh, okay.
Well, that's him now.
So, I told the friends and the barkada, the family of Mike's, I was ready naman. Parang I was planning to do it August sa anniversary. And then initial plan was New York kasi that's one special place sa kanya. Mm-hmm. That's where she studied for a time. Central Park, and she loves Friends, yung sitcom. So parang saktong-sakto na. Tapos very private and all. Okay. Eh, biglang may dumating na blessing. Which I really am thankful for, yung Idol Philippines. So after PBB, I was gonna plan na for those papuntang August. But Idol Philippines happened. I said, oh my Lord, I think this is your way of saying, teka lang, relax ka muna. Kailangan mo munang gawin to. And that's what I did. Okay? That's what I did. I finished Idol Philippines. And then after Idol Philippines, I was planning for certain dates na. Kasi tapos na eh. Wala na yung August, September na natapos yung Idol. Do I do it November or December? Tapos December naman, parang napupunoy na yung mga dates because of certain inquiries. And babalik na, face-to-face events na eh.
Yeah.
Iisip ko, parang sayang yata. Sayang kasi that could help the
wedding.
The wedding. It could help the home that we're gonna be building. So, ano ba? Gawin ko na ba to? Kailan? Eh, tinis ko lang si Maiqui na, you wanna go to Japan? And then she said that to her sister. Her sister said, okay, ayusin na natin, papeles. I got pressured bigla na. We had a 2-week or 3-week window, no?
Two weeks lang. We only planned Japan.
To get the visa and all.
to get the visas. Ako, okay ako sa visa ko eh.
It was
but 2 weeks, hindi pa ako nakapaalam sa parents, sa family. But I told them I was ready na. I had the ring February, March pa lang. I was ready, but I didn't get to ask for their permission. But I found a schedule na to talk to the parents of Maiqui. And then, ang hirap pala. Ang hirap pala. Parang nakakaba. They were, I feel they know. Kasi, of course, why would you have a dinner with them na kayo lang? And they were hinting na, what's gonna happen in Japan? Oh, mga ganun si Tito Pao. Mga ganun siya. Oh, Japan, no? Oh, Japan, no? Sabi ko, yes po. Wait lang. Kukuha na ako ng mga ibang shot. Siguro on my fourth shot, I will tell you. And then eventually, I told them na I'm planning to do this in Shibuya. They laughed. Siyempre, sabi nila, grabe naman, bakit Shibuya of all places? Before that, I was trying to calm myself pala. Sabi ko, I am sorry. Medyo kinakabahan po ako because this is the first time that I'm doing this. And then they both laughed. Sabi nila, hopefully it's your last. Kasi tama naman. Tama naman. It was just a great conversation that led up to me asking na I would like to get your blessing to ask for your daughter's hand. And I promise that I will take care of her. Yun, simple.
Okay.
With, syempre, with the choking, tapos with the teary-eyed. Magan ganun.
Okay.
During this process pala, Fads, nalaman ko na iyakin pa ako.
Na iyakin ka pala?
Oo, even when I asked for a meeting with her grandparents as well. Kasi sobrang close ng family. Okay. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Not only the parents, I had to meet the grandparents as well.
Yeah. Ayan. Yeah. Okay. Okay, so fast forward, Japan.
Japan.
Ano pa, under the guise of Halloween. Ha? Halloween pa kunya.
Oh. So, going to Japan, parang I was messaging sila Catherine and Danielle na, bro, I'm gonna go to Japan. Sabi na, kami rin. Okay yan. Kasi I'm really close with sila Danielle and Catherine. And then si Joshua, same kami ng handler. So Joshua, the handler told me, oh, mag-Japan din si Josh kasama si Catherine. So I messaged them all, I'm gonna do this. I'm gonna propose.
Okay.
And I was like, bro, we're so excited. Okay, let me know. Let us know how we can help. Okay, here's the plan. Shibuya Crossing, I need you guys to parang fend off the crowd sa gitna. But at least may magic circle dun sa gitna ng Shibuya. Okay na. And then, fast forward, Halloween happened. We went around. I have to tell you, it was one of the most difficult moments in my life. And I can tell Mike's right now na hindi ka mahihirapan sa akin kasi hindi ko kayang magsinungaling. I can't hide anything from her.
Uh-uh.
And she knows it. Kasi the days leading up to that day, that certain night, I was so tensed. Tapos I was just doing this like, we were just walking, ah. Tapos nag-ocular ako sa Japan, sa Shibuya. It's like, oh my God.
How will I do this?
Man, ito na pala yun.
For the sake of ano pa sa mga tao, di ba, parang yung kiyapo, di ba?
Oo, yun yung kiyapo ng Japan. Medyo, ano naman, so maganda.
Okay.
Yeah,
and so finally, you're able to create that magic circle.
Yes. That night was so stressful. So we were in Shiodome, sa area na yon, and going to Shibuya, you have to take that Ginza line. Hindi ko talaga mawala sa isipan ko kasi talaga, ngayon pa lang, oh, kinakabahan pa rin ako. And then yung mga moments na yun, buti na lang, I got to talk to my family and they were reassuring me na kaya mo yan. And I had one of my closest friends with me. Ano ka ba? Relax ka lang. You got this. You got this. I was, to be honest, and this is not to be mayabang and all, I am so in love with Mike's to the point that she would say yes. I was more afraid of what's gonna happen next. Kaya ako yung parang
kabado.
Sobrang kabado ako. And internally, that was just my prayer na, Lord, it's not me anymore. It's not just for me asking God na, please make Mike's the best woman for me. But it's more of, Lord, please make me the best guy for Mike's. Kasi sana hindi ako yung mali sa kanya. So that was my internal battle. That was my internal tug of war na.
Yeah. Wow. So Mike's, we'll let you have the final word, Mike's.
Well, it's true. He's not very good at hiding. It was a bit obvious. He was emotional the whole week. He kept asking me questions like, why me? Why do you choose me? Why do you? So I was like, why are you asking all these things?
Para atang inihintay niya ikaw mag-propose, Mikes.
I know. So I had a, admittedly, I had a feeling that it was something was going to happen. I just didn't know where. I didn't know when. You know, there were other ideas in my head. Oh, maybe it's Disneyland because we went to Disneyland and I super love Disney. Or maybe it's Mount Fuji because we also went to Mount Fuji. But this guy, in his crazy self, decides to do it in Shibuya Crossing, which I never would have ever expected. So even if I knew, there was still that element of surprise. I was genuinely super still shocked. Even if, of course, my answer would be yes. It was like there's this sudden shock where you just freeze and you're like, oh my God, this is happening. It's real. And then the thing with his father, it's in the crossing. So there's only like a number of seconds. Because if not, the light will turn red and then we're going to get run over. So it was literally our say yes or we die kind of moment. But of course, I would say yes anyway. It just took a while because I was in shock. So when he asked it again and I finally said yes, he put the ring on, we hugged, and then we ran.
Ran.
We had to run so that we wouldn't get
run over. Hindi talaga yung ano, no, yun yung forever.
Yeah. Oh no, we don't want that. So just in time.
So we promise na okay, this is the first episode. Pero pag either before the wedding or after the wedding, we'll have you over again. So again, congratulations, Mikes. Congratulations,
you,
Robi. And,
thank
and
you,
actually, I'm very happy for the two of you because I can see how much you love each other and how much you really get along with each other. No, so congratulations. And thank you for giving us this first conversation about your engagement. So thank you very, very much. And I hope a lot of the young people out there will be inspired by your story. And sana yung mga gusto na mag-propose, matuto, Rob, dito sa kwento ninyo. No? Kasama dun yung nervyos, di ba?
Oo, kasama yan. My key takeaway from this is, you know, allow yourself to get surprised and be surprised.
Galing, galing. Yeah. Thank you. So we'll have more surprises. Thank you very much. Thank you, Mike. Thank you, Robi. And
thanks,
and have a long and happy life together. Thank you.
Amen.